Good morning. Where am I today? Well, to be honest, the weather's not very good today. It's about 9 degrees in Celsius there, so pretty cool. So I'm in the rolling hills of Northumberland in a place called Bellingham. I think years ago, well, I'm saying years ago, a long time ago, it was famous for its ironworks and smelting down iron and things like that. But long gone are those days. It all comes cheap from China. But who am I to argue? So I'm in the rolling hills. I'm in a place, I'm looking for a place called Hareshaw Linn. And it goes along the Hareshaw Burn. And it's just a nice little walk. And there might be a little cheeky waterfall and some plant life to have a look at. So it's all about relaxation today. It's very misty. Because of that, I've seen quite a lot of wildlife on the way here. Very windy roads, except for when I hit the road built by the Romans when they were here. And I'm a big fan of the Romans. Yes, I know it was an invading empire, but they improved a lot of things. And they made nice straight roads, which I appreciate. The council don't seem to be able to do that. So because of that, I saw an owl came out of the mist. Fantastic. It just swooped out. No sound and whoosh. They're fantastic. And I've seen multiple pheasants. I've seen partridge this morning and rabbits. So I've had to slow down multiple times not to kill them in the car. So come on, let's hit that map. Enough mucking about and me chit-chatting. Let's hit the map and recce. Right, let's find out where we are. So let's hit this map. There we go. Straight into Google Maps. Right, so I'm currently near a place called Armstrong Square, next to an equestrian place, and ye old English crafts. I haven't got ye oldie, but it's near enough. So as you can see, if I scroll out, this is Bellingham. Well, I'm covering the name where I'm parked here, Bellingham, near Bellingham Golf Club. And I want to head up a track which goes up here, you see it, and then you keep going until you get to a waterfall. So I just want to see what's knocking about. And like I say, you go up the Hareshaw Burn to get there, and you cross over it multiple times. So let's change to a satellite view. That makes more sense. So where are we? That's where I am. That's where I'm parked. So we're going to continue up this river. It's Burn, sorry. Crossing it multiple times. Bing, bang, bong, like a fruit machine. Until you get to... So heading northerly. Now there's a marker there, but I don't know if that's true. And then that one seems probably more like it. So we'll see what we can see today. I can hear a mad chicken in the background and a cockerel, but other than that, never seen a single person. Only thing I've seen is wildlife, so I'm looking forward to that. So it looks pretty wild. Look at this area here, yeah, fantastic. So let's get out with it. Here's a useful plant. I know I've probably mentioned it before, but dock leaf. There you go, dock. So I use them for nettle bites and things like that. So, I mean, you can do it how you want it, but I've always, since a kid, I've always scrunched it up as much as I could, then smash it up with your finger, smash it up with a nail so you get the juices coming out. Do you see the juices there? See them all? So once they come out, mix that with a bit of spit and get it on the, for example, nettle stings and things like that. And it does help, to a degree anyway. It's certainly not going to miraculously cure you in seconds, but it does help. Here's some of those aforementioned nettles that I was talking about. So
these things here that have tiny little hairs on. I'll try and zoom in so you can see them. But sometimes it's not so easy to see. See those little hairs next to that little inset there? They sting you. So that's why I mentioned try and get a dock leaf. Carry one with you, because the weird thing is, generally you find plants together that work together. So the dock leaf will get rid of the sting, and they always seem to grow in the same area as these things. They're quite an interesting plant, actually. You can actually cook these. You've got to blanch them or put them in fire to get rid of the stings, but you can't eat them. Found a small waterfall. It's got to be bigger than that. So I tell you what's quite interesting about this place, there's a lot of little tracks going off where something's pushed through the leaf litter and the grass and things like that. That could be people walking their dogs, or could be foxes or anything. So I'm going to check out all those little trails and see if I can find a proper waterfall, because as you can hear in the background, probably there's a small one. But the bird life here is fantastic, listen to them. How can that fail to not cheer anyone up, those tweets? Right, I'm off. Just taking a break here and listen to those birds. Reminds you of a summer's day, and although it is technically a summer's day here, lot of mist, so viewing distance is very poor. It's down to, you know, a quarter of a mile, not even that. But it's very secluded here. I haven't seen a single person, which is nice, nice and relaxing. Listen to those birds. Anyway, time to make a move. There's the river down there, or the burn. channel in there. Look what I've found. Look at this. Excellent examples of, I think, if you look underneath, yeah, and then give it the tap. Hear that? That, I think, is a horse hoof fungus. Look at them. Absolutely massive. There's my hand. So look. They look absolutely fantastic. Look at the white underbellies. They're brilliant. And the bigger they get, the harder they get. Listen. That almost sounds like a bit of balsa wood now. Fantastic stuff. Okay. That's almost like wood. And that's so... if I can get a bit off. Oh, there you go. Look at the texture. It's almost like sort of old conker or walnut. They're strange things. There you go. So great little find there. And there's some little ferns coming out. So it's interesting, you know, you're walking along and there's a dead, well, it's dead fall really, or someone's chopped this for whatever reason and it's come down. Look at the life in here. So you've got horse hoof fungus, you've got all this carpet of moss here, you've got ferns growing. That looks like a type of sphagnum moss. There's loads of different types of sphagnum moss over the planet. I mean, there's not so many in this country, but look, there's another fern coming up. And then look, small flowers. I mean, it's amazing how nature swiftly takes everything back. You know, nothing goes to waste. This all decomposes and gets used, and there'll be ants and insects all over this, I presume. Obviously, the birds can feed on it. Can't spot anything else on it. But I just had a little look off the track here, and I thought, aha, look what I've spotted. So it's fantastic here, look. Really, really dense, thick woodland. And it feels quite natural, even though it looks like it's been thinned at some point. There are, you know, there's not a lot on the floor. There's the usual stuff that fills in the gaps. So someone's cleaned this at some point, but it's, other than that, it's pretty sort of wild. Haven't spotted any insects yet. Now there's bound to be some knocking about in here. Black beetles love this sort of thing. This is already turning into like a compost. It's amazing. Anyway, I've bored you enough with fungus, so I'm off. I've just been making my way through the undergrowth here. There's some amazing plants, but look. I know I've explained this probably in one of my other videos, but see this stuff here? Now, on first inspection, what would you think that is? It looks to me like someone's come past and they've spat. Obviously, spittle from their mouth. But I'll get a better view. I'll turn around here. In fact, look at that. There's a moth down there. See him? See if you just stop for a second and look around you. Look at the things you find. Incredible. Not sure on the species of that one. There's some wild garlic over there. Right, back on this stuff that looks like spittle. So it looks like someone's spat on there and it's just been left, but it's not. That's actually done by an insect. Now, I know what that is, so I want you to put in the comments section what the insect is and what's under there and what comes out, okay? So you may have noticed it, and some people don't see it and just literally think it's spit, but it isn't. So if you know what it is, stick it in the comments section, okay? So let's continue. Let's get out of here, because I want to try and find this waterfall. Now, you know how I like to find a little fungi, or fungi if you're an expert. Now, there's the size of my hand. Let's see if I can spot any fungi in here. No, got to be some around. Holy, what the... Look at the size of that. And it's a multi-tier. Look. Just so you can appreciate the scale, there's my hand. Look. Oh. There's a cow going mad over there. I feel like I'm on bullseye. But look at that. Very vibrant orange as well. Multi-tier. It's in incredible shape as well. So what a find. So there's obviously something going on in this tree here which allows that to colonize. But yeah, if you look at the top, it's on its last leg. So as soon as one thing goes, something else pops up. So nature's fantastic. I wonder what's up there. It sounds like there's a load of cows having a fight. This area stinks. Now that's in a good way, because this stuff here, you can recognize it from the flowers and the leaf with the groove. Yeah, that is. I'm just getting a tap by flies here. That is wild garlic, so you can cook with that. Sometimes I think in non-European places they call it bear garlic, but we obviously don't have any bears here now. But it stinks, and it comes out pretty early in the year. That's how you can tell, but please be very careful. And I've mentioned this in the past video. You can cook with it, but take a note of the flowers. See them? They're like little stars. Do not get that confused with bluebells and things like that, because you'll make yourself ill and you'll probably die. So I have warned you, okay? I don't want anyone to get into any harm, but it's brilliant stuff. You can wrap stuff in it. There's different ways of cooking. You can even make like a little pesto with it. I've done that before. It's a different flavour to standard garlic, but I like it. It kind of reminds me a little bit of garlic greens, which is a Chinese thing, where you let the garlic bulb sprout and the green that comes out the top, you cut that up almost like a chive, and you fry it in like a green onion, like a green onion leaf. And it's got a brilliant flavour. I really like that with egg and things like that. So excellent wild edible there. Just please be careful. If you don't know what you're doing, don't touch it. End of. Don't argue with TrailTrek. But you can tell from the smell anyway, it's reeking. But then, of course, what happens is people go, well, I can smell it, so it must be wild garlic, and it's next to some bluebells. So people get very ill, so please be careful. But very secluded here. I still haven't found this bloody waterfall, so God knows where it is. I found a smaller one, but I'll just continue. The wildlife here is fantastic because it's like a natural gorge as well. It's very heavily covered. The bird songs, they're absolutely amazing. There's a blackbird just flown up there, two of them. Jousting away. They're absolutely fantastic. So I'm going to make tracks here and see if I can find this bloody waterfall. Look at this. How many coins do you think are in there? Look at them all. Now this is obviously a traditional thing. I know there's a Scottish island where there's a tree where if you're ill, you put a coin in as payment and you used to row around the little island on the loch and then hopefully that would take your illness away. Unfortunately, it doesn't work, but it certainly makes people feel better. And look at all the ones in this tree. I think that's brilliant. So sometimes, you know, places like this can become almost like a shrine. So if there's anyone who's put a coin here who's been ill, I hope you get better soon, because there's nothing worse than being ill. So that's nice to see. It's so peaceful here. I still haven't seen one single person, not even a dog walker. Birds are out. Absolutely fantastic. And there's the burn there, heading down towards the waterfall. Thank you.
Right, I'm back. About 4.5 miles. Really enjoyed that. Never saw a single person. And listen, I can hear pigeons there. Fantastic. Still just hear bird life, no sign of humans, which is sometimes for the best. Okay, so about 4.5 miles, so it's supposed to be like a mile up the burn, but that's probably as the crow flies, so unfortunately you're looking at about 4 miles. Understand that I have to go backwards and forwards, backwards and forwards to take certain shots, a bit like on Survivor Man, so there's only me, and then I have to edit it all down, so it will take longer. I'm going to give this marks out of 10. I would give it an 8, and I'll tell you why. Secluded, easy to get to, free parking, no one around, loads of bird life, seats easily accessible for everyone, not too far. Fantastic, what more do you want? And then at the end, you get a lovely view of the waterfall. I was really impressed with that waterfall. It was much bigger than I expected. I've been to a few waterfalls, and that one was pretty good. It's even better than the Ruttering Linn one that I went to. That was a little bit smaller, but still more secluded. You're going to get less people there. And that had the Neolithic rock art as well, which is very interesting. I don't think this area is quite as steeped in history. I'm just going to close the door here, because I can hardly hear myself for all those pigeons. So, highly enjoyed it. Now, I've got myself a treat, because I haven't had anything to eat today. So, this should power me up. So, it's called Deliciously Ella. Don't know if you can see there. There you go. Hard to see. Deliciously Ella. So, I'm going to try this. It says it's an energy ball. Cashew and ginger. So, cashews, I'm thinking of the Orient. And lovely milky cashews, and then ginger, I'm thinking of Kingston in, or Jamaica, full of, oh. Unfortunately, actually it smells like ginger beer, and I'm a big fan of ginger beer, I really like it. So this is, I'll show you what you actually get here. Essentially, it looks, do you know what? It looks like some cookie dough. It's hard to see because there's too much light coming in. There you go. It looks like cookie dough. It seems to have the texture of it as well. And it looks like one of those things you give to the birds with a suet. Right, let's give it a shot. Enough waffling. Well, I like that. Great Taste Awards 2017. How can I explain it? It's a bit like, do you know what? It's like eating a suet ball for the birds with some ginger in it. I don't hate it. I'll finish it, but marks out 10 for that. Bloody hell. Gluten-free oats. Good God. Everything's gluten-free these days. I think it's bad for your heart, wasn't it? Gluten-free. I'll give that a 3. It's edible. Anyway, so highly recommend getting here. Only downside is, excuse me for talking while I'm eating. However, I'm going to give it a little markdown because it's not wheelchair accessible. And I know I've had comments from people saying, what's the point in having an outdoor show and then waiting on about wheelchairs? Well, I want everyone to enjoy it. And sometimes tiny little changes can be for the better, so everyone can enjoy it. But unfortunately, it's too rugged. You wouldn't be able to enjoy it. If you've got a stick or something, you might be all right. Well, as long as you like adventuring. So I highly recommend coming here. Never seen anybody, which is fantastic. I love it. Get yourself down here. And you know, I'm going to have to see it. I'm going to have to see it before I spit this out and stop the video. I will see it. Get out! I've done it, so come on, you have a shot. And share it with your friends. Do old Trail Trek a favour. Right, bye-bye.